Testing the Authenticity of Recordings Used as Evidence, Part 5.
Badania identyfikacyjne
Tests to identify individuals on the basis of analysis of continuous speech comprise numerous stages, which include an auditory evaluation of the evidentiary material and the comparative material, and the instrumental or measurement stage. The methodology we use in single tests to identify persons is called the language measurement method. Thus, we have to consider language characteristics, linguistic and phonetic, as well as the physical parameters of a given voice.
Oraz fizyczne cechy, parametry fizyczne głosu.
Contrary to popular belief, our tests do not focus on voice analysis as such.
Analizie głosu jako takiego. Bardziej koncentrujemy
we concentrate
się
more on factors connected with
ciągu,
continuous speech rather than on isolated phonemes,
głosami,
words,
słowami,
or phrases.
Zdaniami, tylko właśnie
the phonetic context is what is important to us. If we are analyzing phonetic characteristics and the context in which a particular statement was made, because the manner of formulating thoughts, building sentences, using melody, inserting pauses or accents, whether in words or in phrases, are all strictly individual characteristics. The speaker may influence these. He can modify and change, but in a very limited range. The least impact is on the phonetic characteristics. It would seem relatively simple, but only in situations where we are focused only on individual elements. However, we must bear in mind the fact that we analyze, in essence, bundles of characteristics, whether it be dialectical influences or even the method of articulation, and in the end, the language we speak in. Grammar is known commonly, and we are obligated to use the language in accordance with prescribed norms. Nevertheless, the method we realize these norms is very individual. What we isolate are most often bundled characteristics. However, the group of characteristics is individual. The broader the group we are able to identify, then analogous to processing continuous signals into digital ones, the greater the sampling frequency, the greater the fidelity of the reproduced reality, that is, the continuous signal.
Tym siłą rzeczy wierność odtwarzania tej rzeczywistości, czyli tego sygnału ciągłego, jest lepsza. To samo można przełożyć.
The same can be applied to our identification testing. The more characteristics we isolate, the more precisely and with a greater likelihood of probability will we identify the speaker.
Etap badań
the stage that depends on an auditory evaluation and which characteristic we analyze in general were presented in the previous fragments of this program.
Omawialiśmy w poprzednim odcinku. W tej chwili
now I'd like to present, also in a general way of showing the idea of these tests, several measurement methods used in our testing.
Kilka metod pomiarowych, które stosujemy w tych naszych badaniach. Może nie wszyscy wiedzą,
perhaps not everyone knows that in order to identify a speaker, the recorded evidence material must be compared with something.
Materiał, którym się dysponuje, tak zwany dowodowy, z czymś porównać. I są to badania,
these are, first and foremost, comparative tests. First, we extract the characteristics and describe them in relation to the evidentiary material. We do the same things with regard to the comparative material, and the results obtained are compared with one another.
I tak jak powiedziałam, w tym etapie badań,
what sorts of things are we able to measure at this stage of testing? What is available in the speech signal that can be described, translated into numbers, and be presented as numerical results? One piece of equipment that allows us to describe, to visualize, and then analyze characteristics we are interested in is the sonograph. This sonograph is so programmed that it can analyze, for example, so-called format structures. This screen is constructed in such a way that we have the sonograph at the bottom arranged in the following manner. The horizontal axis represents time, while the vertical, frequency. However, the saturation of specific fragments of this image are evident of a third dimension, the energy of the signal at a given moment and at a given frequency. Looking at the screen of this sonograph, we can clearly see this sort of lines, which are types of curves.
Tych poprzecznych prążków, które są jakimiś krzywymi. I w naszym zainteresowaniu
for us, every line represents a certain form and frequency, generally referred to as simply formants. We are interested, first of all, in determining for a given person whether or not the individually numbered lines, each line represents formats, here, here, and here. The question is, for any given person, do these lines always appear on the same phoneme, in the same places, in terms of frequency, and are their maxima always found on the same frequencies? Of course, to an accuracy of a range of variation, because no one is able to repeat the same phrase, the same word, or even the same phoneme exactly the same way. Thus, this is the range of variation, but it differs for every individual. First, we ask whether these frequencies match. And second, does the next phoneme always influence those shapes in the same manner? If we were to isolate and look at only this fragment, the voiced part of the phoneme, then we would see certain stabilization of the shape. But here it's another story. The entire picture, both the vertical and horizontal distribution, form a picture of the individual. This concerns every phoneme, because the distribution of vowels will always differ from one another in terms of the location of lines.
Będzie się między sobą różniło u każdego zawsze i między innymi po tym będzie można rozpoznać.
This is one way, among others, that we are able to tell what sort of phoneme it is, a vowel or a consonant.
Ale te zmiany dotyczą również.
These changes also characterize the speaker, assuming it's the same phoneme.
Każdy z nas a powie
each of us says a differently, in a characteristic manner. The distribution of formants will be characteristic for every person. Being able to observe such events and count the energy maxima, the range of changes, and calculate the mutual relationships in various situations, in different tempos, with different speech rhythms, and, most important, in phonetic context, the area around the phonemes, we try to use all possible types of equipment which give us a chance to calculate these parameters.
Mając dostępne te cechy i mając możliwość policzenia, staramy się zaprząc wszelkie możliwe urządzenia, które dają taką właśnie możliwość obliczania tych parametrów, zaprząc do pomocy nam. Bo wiadomo, my możemy sobie tutaj i teraz może pokażę, że
now I'll show you that even this sonograph makes that possible.
Proszę bardzo, na dolnym ekranie,
on the lower screen,
z góry na dół,
I'll move a red cursor from top to bottom,
tą czerwoną kreską,
this red line.
Czyli nastawiam na przykład
I set the stabilized cursor on the time axis.
A tu w osi czasu mam ustabilizowany ten kursor. Efekt jest jaki?
The graph przedstawia shows a cross section along this cursor.
Wzdłuż tego kursora. Czyli na tej osi
on this axis we plot frequency.
Na tej
and on this one the equivalent of gray saturation.
Czyli jeżeli ja przesuwam
if I move the cursor on the lower screen down
na dolnym ekranie w dół
and set it at the lowest point of the second line, then I read the maximum value here at the top. And at the bottom, see at what frequency. In this case,
1380 Hz.
Moving further to the left, we run into the next maximum value. But all the time in a given moment of speech. That's why this picture must be stabilized, in order to be able to analyze how it changes in the time a phoneme lasts. I'm moving the time cursor in the direction of the mid-phoneme, which results in changes in the curve. At each moment, it is different. If we had to make such measurements manually, as I'm presently doing, for evidential material lasting 30 minutes, then we would have to make 1,000,000 of them, and it would take years. Therefore, we are interested in the shape which we can compare with the analyzed samples. Everything that can be counted, we turn over to specialized programs, written especially for this task.
Skonstruowanym, napisanym tylko pod kątem właśnie tego typu zastosowań. Pokażę przykładowe wydruki, jakie możemy uzyskać przy pomocy tego rodzaju programu.
Here we have sample printouts that we can obtain with the help of this sort of program. We have an envelope with the signal, the equivalent of this window. Here is the time axis, which tells us where in the statement we are located. This is the printout, so it is of poorer quality. We do not analyze printouts, we only use the screen. Printouts, however, are necessary to compare pictures.
Natomiast, żeby zebrać wyniki obliczeń, to proszę bardzo, przebieg tych czerwonych.
We can see these red dots on the graph are in line with the shape of these increases, of these lines on the graph.
Wzmocnień tych prążków. Każda taka kropeczka.
Each dot is calculated and positioned by the computer.
Zestawiona. I jeżeli mamy do dyspozycji.
If we have evidentiary material and comparative material arranged the same way, then we can compare the numerical results.
Otrzymane wyniki numeryczne możemy ze sobą.
There are programs that do this as well.
I następnie obliczyć.
Then we can calculate the correlation coefficient and determine on the basis of the number of parameters which are the same whether or not the two speakers could be the same person.
Się zgadza, pokrywa, czyli na ile ci mówcy mogą być jedną osobą. Dolna część tego
the lower part of the graph shows a single line.
Linię, widzimy, że tu jest.
We see here another frequency graph, which only goes to 350 Hz, while in the center window it goes to 4000. The lower part of the graph serves to analyze the intonation line of the entire statement. It includes such elements as melody and accent. This is influenced not only by individual preferences, but also by tempo, rhythm, emotional state, mental state, health, and all those factors that can be reflected in speech.
Wszystkie te czynniki, które mogą w jakikolwiek sposób znaleźć odzwierciedlenie w mowie. Jest to po prostu
it's an analysis of the larynx tone.
Gdyby poprowadzić tu obwiednie,
if we draw an envelope along this graph,
krzywej,
we obtain an undulating line that has its maximum values and dips every so often.
Linię falującą uzyskamy, która ma swoje maksima, co jakiś czas obniża się. Właśnie te obwiednie, próbka po próbce.
It is these envelopes, sample by sample, which can be computed and presented together with the exact calculation of individual format frequencies. That is, the position where a given line is located at the moment the analysis is conducted, which the program is able to precisely count. Format 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Pierwszy, drugi, trzeci, czwarty i wyższy, którego tutaj nie widać. Również F0.
We also have F0 at the moment of analysis and the number of the sample presented by the graph,
którą to ten dany wykres przedstawia. Mając do dyspozycji tak specjalistyczne
with such a specialized computer program, We must remember that the person who decides on the success of these results, that is, their trustworthiness, or that the degree of correlation came out with, say, let's say 0.8, 0.9, that person is the operator. Also significant is the technical quality of the material compared. Most often we receive recorded telephone conversations of average quality, and we have to compare it to comparative material also obtained over a telephone. We come now to the general problem of collecting comparative material. You cannot properly collect comparative material if you are not familiar with the evidentiary material. The manner in which tests are conducted, especially those given numerical descriptions, as well as many dealing with linguistic events, also require such an approach. We are not able to collect comparative material that will ensure the sufficient occurrence of characteristics that require confirmation or elimination, if we are not familiar with the evidentiary material. All the analyses that will be done in detail during tests of individual identification should be done earlier, before collecting comparative material. Obviously, we need to compare comparable material, both in terms of technical quality and forms of speech. Other forms of speech may also be recorded, such as text which is read, repeated, or memorized, in addition to spontaneous speech, the most common form of evidentiary material.
Wypowiedzi spontanicznych, bo najczęściej ze spontanicznymi mamy do czynienia w materiale dowodowym, ale jednak należy również brać pod uwagę, że materiał porównawczy służy
comparative material allows characteristics being analyzed to be revealed.
I tu czynniki tego rodzaju jak stres, jak
factors which play a large role here include stress, reluctance or lack of cooperation on the part of the person providing comparative material. Others are those factors which are difficult to reproduce. For example, strong emotional perturbation, emotions associated with something unpleasant. For example, it's very difficult to replicate the conditions of an argument, even if the person from whom we are collecting the samples cooperates with us. However, often these individuals do everything possible to render the tests impossible. In terms of the comparative material itself, there are several types. We do not always invite the person to the studio in order to record our conversation. Often, other recordings, treated as evidentiary material in other cases and obtained openly during the course of earlier proceedings, such as during a search, for example, these materials are used as comparative material. This type of material is often used in kidnapping cases.
Bardzo często wykorzystuje się tego rodzaju materiały, to znaczy mamy zarejestrowane wypowiedzi, które telefoniczne oczywiście na ogół.
We have recorded telephone conversations that are taped after the person has been kidnapped. In order to perform identification tests, before the police have made any arrests, the suspected kidnapper's residence is searched. Any type of recorded material, whether video or audio, found there serves as comparative material for us. Some of the material, both evidentiary and comparative, is classified confidential to varying degrees. These are activities done at the operational stage, where very specific legal rules apply. In order for such evidentiary evidence to be used in a trial, numerous conditions must be met and all sorts of documentation applied.
I oczywiście to jest udokumentowane na wiele sposobów, także nie ma właściwie.
It is therefore not possible for an expert who needs comparative material in a case concerning ransom demands for return of a stolen car to call and tape record random telephone conversations, later selecting from among them suspected persons with insidious intentions without their knowledge.
Tymi osobami telefonującymi, bez ich wiedzy, z jakimiś takimi podstępnymi intencjami. Takie rzeczy nie wchodzą w grę, to tego się nie praktykuje. Pobieranie materiału porównawczego...
Collecting comparative material in the studio in order of the institution in charge of the investigation is the most common form of obtaining such material.
Zresztą wtedy in such cases,
it is done by experts.
To robić. I procedura jest bardzo
the procedure
prosta.
Is very straightforward. The entire process is written up. The person is informed when the recording is started and when it is stopped. The person is told how everything will be done before beginning. Everything is recorded. A protocol is written up where the type and method of recording is described. The person who has been summoned signs the protocol and adds any comments and stipulations. That is the most common way comparative material is collected.